Another way of checking if those grammar is an LL1 grammar is to create the parse table. That means, well, you can, in that you can see if you have a given variable and a given input symbol, if you only have one possibility to derive the next input symbol from the variable. So here you write down the terminals you may get, including the dollar sign, so the word and sign, and here you have those variables. Oh, that was not pretty. So this is our parse table, and now we can use the first sets to fill out the table. So with the S, and this is one rule from the S. So you see, S has this rule: S goes to terminal A, big A, B, which is that. And that means with this rule you can get NA as next input symbol. So you write down that rule. And as you can see, you can also use the second rule of S, which is this one, which also gives you an A. And I show you how to fill out the whole table so that you know how to do it. And as you see, this rule can also give you a B. So I write down this rule into that cell as well. So now let's have a look at the A. A derives to S, so we take the first set of the S, and there you have B and A. That means the rule A goes to S can give you either B or A, so I write it into both cells. Here this rule can give me an A, and here this rule can give me a B. Now we can have the B as well, and let's take a look at the first. So those B can give you, of course, a terminal B, and this B can also give you the empty string. And now, because you have an epsilon production, you also have to include the follow set of B. So if B derives to epsilon, then a B rule can or could also give you one of that as a next symbol. So B goes to epsilon could also lead to a next A or to a next end of word. And as you see in the it's the same as in the last video. You have in this cell both entries, and if you have in one cell two entries, then you can't do deterministic LL1 parsing, because if you have the case that this is your variable, this is your next variable where you want to derive something from, and you know that the next symbol from the input string is an A, then you don't know which of these rules you have to take. So again, wrong color. Again, no, this grammar does not allow you deterministic LL1 parsing.